In this video, we will be discussing co-ownership part 1 of 3. Co-ownerships are of two types. First, we have joint tenancy. This is where each of the co-owners own one single share in the property. Whereas, on the other hand, we have tenancy in common. This is where co-owners own their respective undivided shares in the property. For joint tenancy to be formed, all four unities are required to be present, as elaborated in AG Securities versus Bond. First unity is unity of title, which means conveyance of the property to all the owners must have been through one single document. Second is unity of time, which requires conveyance to have occurred at same time. Third is unity of interest. This requires similar interest of all the co-owners as to the land. And lastly, unity of possession, whereby no co-owner may exclude the other co-owners from the property, as seen in Mayer versus Riddick. On the other hand, for tenancy in common, the only unity required is unity of possession. To check which type of tenancy we have, we need to answer three questions. First is, are the four unities present? If the answer to this is no, then it is tenants in common. If the answer to this is yes, then we need to answer the question number 2. Question number 2 is, are there any words of severance? If the answer to this is yes, then it is tenants in common. If the answer to this is no, then we have to answer the last question, question number 3. Question number 3 is there a situation where equity presumes tenants in common? If there is such a situation, then it is tenancy in common. If the answer to this is a no, then it is joint tenancy. One important concept to grasp for this topic is that whenever a co-ownership is formed, a trust is automatically formed thereby. For understanding how it works, we need to know that generally the owner of the property have a legal interest in the land as well as the equitable interest. But the maximum number of legal owners that can be registered for a property is 4. Where the number of co-owners exceeds 4, only 4 of these owners will be registered as legal owners, and these 4 owners will have both legal interest in the land as well as the equitable interest. Whereas the co-owners other than these 4 will only have equitable interest in the land and they will be beneficiaries, whereas the 4 legal owners will be the trustees who will hold the land in trust for these beneficiaries.